Hey everyone, I hope you all are doing great. So welcome to Vet It's You YouTube channel. In this video, we will continue with the histology of the salivary glands. So let's get started. In the previous video, we were discussing about the classification of the salivary glands and completed till parotid salivary gland. Now talking about the another type of the salivary gland, that is mandibular salivary gland. This gland is a seromucous or a mixed compound tubulo-acinar gland. Basically, the secretions of the mandibular salivary gland is a mixture of the serous plus mucus secretory product, and structurally it is a compound tubulo-acinar gland, a gland having branching tubules of which ends in a secretory acinus. Secretory acinus are just the rounded secretory unit present in the salivary gland. Another characteristic morphological structure of the mandibular salivary gland is that the structure unit or the secretory units present in the gland is somewhat variable in structure from one species to another species. And the common link is that they consist of a tubular unit with an enlarged terminal acinus. It simply implies that the structure of the secretory unit can differ in different animals, but they consist of a tubular unit with an enlarged terminal acinus, which is a common feature present in every animal. Before moving forward, I would like to tell you about the serous damilunes. Basically, it is a serous cell that is found at the distal end of the secretory units of certain salivary glands like mandibular salivary gland or sublingual salivary gland. Now talking about the another characteristic of the mandibular salivary gland is that the lumen of the tubule and acinus is bordered with the help of a mucus secreting cells. And the presence of the serous damilunes can be marked at the periphery of these structures. Now the serous secretory product of the mandibular salivary gland reaches the lumen of different tubules with the help of an intercellular canaliculi that occurs between the mucus cell. As I already told you that the secretory product of the mandibular salivary gland consists of the serous plus mucus products. And the serous secretory product released from the different secretory units in the mandibular salivary gland will reaches to the different tubules lumen with the help of an intercellular canaliculi. The intercellular canaliculi is just an extremely narrow tubular channel located between the adjacent cell and help in the transportation of the serous secretory product released from the different secretory units present in the mandibular salivary gland. Now the another characteristic of the mandibular salivary gland, which is species specific, is that in the case of a dogs and cats, the mucus element of the mandibular salivary gland will predominate over the serous one. The myoepithelial cells will present around the different secretory unit and help in the secretions. Now another important characteristic of the mandibular salivary gland is that in the case of a main duct, the epithelium lining consists of the blood cells which secretes the mucus. So basically the presence of the goblet cells in the main duct help in identification of the particular type of a duct, whether it is mandibular, parotid or any other type. Now the another type of the salivary gland is the sublingual salivary gland. It is also a serous mucus compound tubulo-acinar gland, which is just similar to the mandibular salivary gland. The another characteristic of the gland is that the number of the mucus acinus, serous damilunes and the seromucous nature of the secretory product vary among the different species. Like the sublingual glands of the cattle, sheep and the pigs are almost entirely mucus with relatively few serous demilunes. So basically these are the characteristic feature of the sublingual salivary gland present in the different animals. Moving on, the next characteristic of the sublingual salivary gland is that apart from the typical mucus acinus and the serous demilunes, the glands of the dogs and cat contains a cluster of serous acinus with a periodic acid shift PAS positive granules in the basal portion. Basically, the PAS is a staining procedure used commonly in a histological laboratory detection procedures. And here in the case of the salivary gland, it is used for the detection of the salivary gland tumors, which is usually common in the case of the dogs and cats. Moving forward, the mucus cell present in the sublingual salivary gland forms a tubular secretory unit that connects with the serous acinus to the intercalated ducts. Now, with the help of the tubular secretory unit formed with the mucus cell, help in establishment of a connection between the serous acinus with the intercalated ducts. Usually, striated and the intercalated ducts are well developed in most of the animal except dogs and the cats. Now, moving forward, the another characteristic of the sublingual salivary gland is that the interlobular ducts present in the gland have low simple columnar epithelium that increases in height and becomes two-layered when it becomes a larger duct. Basically, here it simply implies that during the course of formation of different ducts, the interlobular duct will transform into the larger duct, and during this course, the simple columnar epithelium of a low height will transform into a columnar epithelium of a high height with the two layers. Now moving on, the main duct of a sublingual salivary gland is lined with the stratified cobordial epithelium, and the goblet cells only occurs in the case of a cattle and a pigs. So this is one of the important characteristic features of a main duct which help in distinguishing it, that the main ducts having goblet cells in the case of sublingual salivary gland found only in the case of cattle and pigs. With this, we have completed the histology of the salivary glands. I hope you understand it well. So please like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel Vet It's You. Thanks for the watching and initiative by Ankit Kaushik.